Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to make a chatbot using Deepseek. You might have heard about this AI because it's very affordable. So in this video, we are going to see how to build it. If you are looking for the source code, check the description. Without any delay, let's get started. First, we are going to initialize our Next.js application. Here, I am using the latest version of the app and I recommend you do the same. You can name your project whatever you want. I am naming it Deepseek Bot. These are the default settings for the project. You can use your own preferences or follow mine. The choice is yours. Wait for a few seconds and let the project installation complete. Next, navigate to the newly created directory and install two npm packages, OpenAI and Lucid React. Yes, Deepseek uses the OpenAI SDK, so we are going to use that. Now open this project in your favorite code editor. If I show you my package.json file, these are the dependencies and their versions I am working with in this project. I recommend using the latest version. Next, create a .env.local file. This is the simplest way to store an API key securely without exposing it. Now let's get the Deepseek API key. Go to Google, search for Deepseek and click on the official link. When the page loads, you will see two options, Start Now and Access API. If you click on Start Now, you will see the Deepseek chatbot interface. Deepseek provides a chain of thought feature for free, which you can use to chat. It's quite good to be honest, but since we are here for the API, go back and click on Access API. First create an account. Once you are logged in, you will see a dashboard that looks something like this. From the left hand panel, you will find the API key option. Click on it, then click on create an API key and name your key. After that, you'll see your API key. Copy this API key and paste it into the .env.local file in your project. Now it's time to write some code. To handle the API key, Next.js handles APIs in a special way. For this, go to the app directory, create an API folder, then inside it, create another folder called chatbot. And finally, create a route.ts file. Here, we'll write the code for the API. First, we import NextResponse from Next.js for handling server-side responses and the OpenAI library to interact with the Deepseek API. Next, we ensure proper error handling by checking if the Deepseek API key is set in our environment variables. If it's missing, we immediately throw an error to avoid running into issues later. Now, we create an OpenAI object, configuring it with the base URL of the Deepseek API and the API key from our environment variables. This object will let us send requests to the Deepseek API. Then we define a post function which will handle incoming HTTP post requests. Inside, we wrap everything in a try-catch block for error handling. First, we extract messages from the request body using req.json. If messages are missing or not in an array format, we return a 400 status response with an error message. Next, we use the openai.chat.completions.create method to generate a response. Here, we specify the Deepseek chat model and include a system-level message saying, "You are a helpful and friendly AI assistant," followed by the user's input messages. If the response doesn't contain any content, we throw an error to signal something went wrong. Finally, if everything works as expected, we return the assistant's response as JSON. If an error occurs at any point, we log it for debugging and send back an appropriate error message with the status code. In short, this code acts as a bridge between our application and the Deepseek API, ensuring robust error handling and clear communication. And finally, we will write the code for the page.tsx file. First, we are importing React hooks like useState, useRef and useEffect, along with some icons from Lucid React for our chat UI. We also define an interface for message to structure the data. Each message has a role, user or assistant, and some content. Now inside the home component, we have got three main state variables: messages to store the chat history, input to handle what the user types, and isLoading to show a loading indicator when the bot is thinking. We also use a useRef called messages_endref to scroll to the latest message automatically. Then we define a helper function scrollToBottom which uses that ref to ensure smooth scrolling. This function gets triggered inside a useEffect whenever the message's state changes. Next comes the handle submit function, which fires when the user sends a message. First, it prevents the default form submission behavior, checks if the input is empty, and ensures no duplicate request when the bot is already responding. It then adds the user's message to the chat and clears the input box. Here's where it gets interesting. After the user's message is added, we send a post request to API chatbot with the full chat history. Once we get the bot's response, we add it to the messages state. If there's an error, we handle it gracefully by showing an error message in the chat. And of course, once all this is done, we toggle is loading back to false. For the UI, we structure it into three main parts: a header with the title AI chat, a chat container that displays all the messages, and an input form for typing and sending messages. Each message is styled based on whether it's from the user or the bot, and the isLoading state shows an animated typing indicator when the bot is generating a response. Lastly, the input box and send button are designed with nice hover effects and are disabled while the bot is processing a response. All in all, this is a fully functional interactive chat interface where the user can type messages, get bot responses, and enjoy a smooth experience. Next, all we need to do is run our project. Open the terminal and use the command npm run dev now. Open the localhost port in your browser and you will see the project in action. This is the modern, simple, and aesthetic look of our chatbot. However, when you try to chat, you will notice the chatbot responds with insufficient balance. This means we need to add some credit, as low as $2 or $5, to start chatting with the bot. Unfortunately, when I tried to add payment, I couldn't because I'm from India, and DeepSeek currently doesn't support Indian payment methods for developers. If you are from another country, you should be able to add a payment and get started. Trust me, this is one of the most affordable AI chatbots out there. Let me know how this project works out for you in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.